Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. The vacant WBA Interim Lightweight Championship of the World. Please welcome into the ring from Ontario, Canada, Tony Louis.
According to the bookmakers, Tony Louis is a slight favourite for this fight. I'm watching him in action against Carl Dargan when he won emphatically on points. He's down in the last round but won widely on points, and Dargan, an undefeated fighter, you can kind of see why. A little bit upright, but he lets his punches go. Good left hand, and he is tough. Shorter than Derry Matthews, but he has got a lot to gain if he wins this one. He would throw himself, like Matthews is now, right into world title contention. Been a pro since 2008. He had been due to have
Please
a fight.
Please welcome into the ring.
Quickly changed
from
his plans. Pro now for 12 years, Derry. Dirty Derry, as he likes to call himself. That goes back to that John Simpson fight, doesn't it? That's a few years ago. I was there at Liverpool Olympia when he just about hit him with every foul shot in the book. It has to be said.
It's amazing how he's been around for so long, boxing at such a high level. And it takes no
left but nobody. Started as a featherweight, an ABA champion. Very good amateur, and now within touching distance of a world title fight proper, and what a great legacy that would be. He says that he just wants people to look at him in 20 years' time and remember his name and say, yeah, Derry Matthews, he can fight.
Well, they will, John, but if he can pick up that world title, he'll be remembered forever.
Well, if I'm still around in 20 years' time, God willing, I'll still be saying it. And a good advert for boxing, brightly popular here.
Well, there's one thing you guarantee with Derry Matthews, and that's 110% effort. He never does not. Whether it's a good fight or not, it's not for his, for the wanting in his heart. He puts everything into every fight. Always have. You have to admire that.
Big heart, and he is a banger. He has that equaliser with both hands. Carried his punching weight up through the divisions from featherweight, now up to lightweight. He's fighting with a slight favourite. Hunger there for his trainer, Danny Bourne. He's been working long and hard in preparations for this fight. Far from ideal. It was supposed to be Avril, then a change of opponent to a southpaw banger, and now to the tough man from Canada. Howard Foster. He's the man who's the third man in the ring tonight, initiating what could, on the basis of what I've seen of both these two fighters, could turn out to be a really entertaining tussle. Danny Matthews, with a lot to lose, he knows that. That interim WBA lightweight title fight will surely now propel him, if he wins this, towards a fight for the real thing.
Ladies and gentlemen, Frank Warren for Queensbury Promotions in association with Greg Cohen Promotions, sponsored by Raynham Steel, proudly presents 12 three-minute rounds for the vacant WBA Interim Lightweight Championship of the World, live from the Echo Arena here in Liverpool. Your officials are appointed by the World Boxing Association, and your three scoring judges at ringside are Stefano Carosa of Italy, Jean-Louis Legland of France, and Dave Paris of the UK. Your WBA steward in charge is Mr. Aurelio Fiengo from Colón, Panama. Your British Boxing Board of Control rep is Les Potts. Your timekeeper at the bell is Andrew East. And when the action begins, your referee in charge is Howard Foster of the UK. And now to introduce the contestants. Firstly, fighting out of the red corner stands the WBC Continental America's lightweight champion, with a record that reads 19 wins, 2 losses, with 7 KOs to his name. At yesterday's weighing, he scaled 9 stone, 8 pounds, and tonight he wears the camouflage shorts. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from Ontario, Canada, Tony Lewis! And across the ring in the blue corner stands the WBA Continental Champion, a man whose record reads 37 wins, 9 losses, 2 draws, with 20 KOs to his name. At yesterday's weigh-in, he scaled 9 stone, 8 pounds, 12 ounces, and tonight he wears the green, white, and gold shorts. Please welcome from the city of Liverpool, Terry Matthews! Your referee will now give his final instructions to both boxers.
Fellas, both you both in the dressing room, you both know I expect keeping clean, but straight away we're told both you are to edge in close. Good luck to you both, just for
ladies and gentlemen, 12 3-minute rounds for the vacant WBA Interim Lightweight Championship of the World.
Well, Barry, Matthews, Lewis, I've kind of tried to sum up what Lewis is about. What do you think are the key factors here? Is Derry going to try and keep it long?
Well, you expect so, you would be in a taller fight with a longer reach. It's just keeping the patience, like he's shown in his last year's fights, the discipline that Matthew has shown, not to be over-eager, not to get in too much of a scrap against what seems to be a really strong opponent.
Well, he certainly is strong, Tony Lewis, and he will keep coming. He likes to get on the front foot, and he likes to dominate. He's had a good look at Derry Matthews, and he says that he knows what Matthews is all about, and he thinks that anything Matthews can do, he can do it in a more superior manner. He'd been due to have another fight, promptly changed the plans when he got this big opportunity, and he says of the whole one-week notice scenario, yeah, I've only had a week's notice for it, but so too has Derry.
That's right, yeah, no, it's not an ideal situation for either fighter, but both training for fights, so, you know, they're both going to be in good condition physically, and you can see that they are. For Derry, sorry, it's been a nightmare, hasn't it? You know, he's been fighting a tall, rangy, real slickster, but it's going to be a chess match to then a southpaw who could bang, and not to a bit of a brawler in Lewis.
A fairly facile victory a few weeks back when he was supposed to have his world title fight for the first time. That's a nice shot from Matthews, good right hand. But there you see the insistence of Lewis. He keeps coming, and he's quick to throw that left hook.
Yeah, but the good thing about Matthews, he didn't panic, kept his gloves applied. Nice good defence there, and then Lewis while away just to the arms.
Who's going to take the early initiative? Who's going to get the nose ahead in this fight first? A nice right hand this time from Lewis gets through, just around the back of that pack. Derry Matthews.
Better from Matthews, yeah, you've got to establish that jab. Got to get the range with that left hand before he lets that right hand over the top. Good.
Good right hand again from Matthews, second time that he's found the target with that overhand right.
And he got close to the body as well for Lewis. Good left hook from Lewis there to the body. Good uppercut back from Matthews. This is good.
Really bright, lively start to this fight. Strong, isn't he? You can see Lewis.
Well, Matthews got to be careful. He's not getting caught in that three-quarter range. You either got to be out the distance or close to the chest of Lewis.
Finding the range. back comes Luiz with a couple of good body shots. He works the body well.
Yeah, good uppercut as well there with the right hand from Luiz.
Well, an intriguing opening round and not much between them.
No, not at all, John.
Distant shots in the right hand of Matthews against the body shots of Luiz.
Yeah, pretty much. I just fancied Matthews, favoured Matthews, I think, for the cleaner work. But you know, it was close and closed the gap a little bit in the end of the round there, Luiz, with a good little attack.
Well, here he is with Danny Vaughan, Derry Matthews.
Right hand, listen to me. Comes in. How are you feeling? That's a nice round, yeah? See when he's coming close, get them elbows in him. He's looking for the left hook round the side.
That's all, got, yeah.
That's all he's got. But I want you to start steeping him. Bring them up the middle a little bit. The fight will settle down now, yeah? Everything you're doing behind the jab, more movement, don't stay still. And you've got a jab, you've got a jab, and you can't set his feet. Okay?
Keep that
and
moving
all the time.
Well, should have taken the words out of your mouth there, Barry. Just the sort of advice you'd want to hear, wouldn't you? Throwing that jab.
Yeah, it not only keeps the guy from attacking, stops him in his tracks, gives you the range for your shots as well, gives you the distance.
Matthews with a slight reach advantage, he's the taller fighter.
It's a nice positive start, though, isn't it, from Luiz? It was a close first round. Ayers Matthews, you couldn't argue if they give it to Luiz, maybe, but it's a good positive start from him. He's coming forward.
Nice body shot, that left hook again, but a nice response off the ropes from Matthews. And again, two solid right hooks.
That was good from Matthews. Yeah, when he threw the left hook there, he just span on his front foot, just trying to keep turning Luiz.
Busy Luiz, though, he has the work rate.
Yeah, that's good from Luiz.
Keep producing that.
That was good from Luiz there, throwing three straight punches coming forward.
Oh, that's good from Matthews again. Quality right hand. He's had some success in the first two rounds with that. But there's a relentless look about those body punches from Luiz. Take some discouraging.
Oh, you can see he's going to come forward all night, can't you? Oh, lovely uppercut there from Matthews, but Luiz just walks through it.
Matthews been training in Marbella, got himself into great shape, but just the worry because of all the setbacks and changes of opponent, just the worry, and you hope it's not a case that he's left something in the gym, that he's kind of peaked too soon.
Well, it was, we trained for the fight, even the train for the high pressure fight like this originally, because a Briola would have been a real technical battle.
Yeah, you've gone from the technical battle to the fight against Barroso, which would have been against the southpaw puncher, against this, which is kind of a much, well, you would suspect, a more attritional sort of fight.
Yeah, it's going to be fought at the frantic pace. You can see that, can't you? It's only going to get busier as the rounds go on.
Not a huge amount in those punches from Luiz, but he keeps throwing.
Again, it's all pressure, all work rate from Luiz. But then the quality shots coming from Matthews.
Foster having a word. From Luiz, which may have been on the borderline.
Good left hook there from Luiz.
Well, a fascinating round, and again, not a lot between them. Work rate from Luiz.
How are you feeling?
Fine.
Okay. He's just settling down into it now. John? Okay. I just want you more of the same and then behind the jab all the time. When you're moving off, it's the half a step that's going to get this kid. And plant your feet. When you're half a step, try it up the middle.
Keep shout shape.
Yeah, shape all the time. When you're aiming shout shape, I want you going back. Now I want to start bringing the left hook into play. Jab, left hook, right hand. Okay? Right. Just here, Jimmy. Left hook, right hand. But everything you're doing behind the jab, but you're nice and looking nice and relaxed and controlled. So the jab's gonna be the key to the fight. I want to see more jabs. When you're on them ropes, try one up the middle and roll them. Roll them. All he's looking for is a left hook round the side. Yeah? And watch the head when I'm as well.
Well, it was a tight fight. That's a lovely uppercut from Matthews off the ropes.
Yeah, and that's only been the difference between them, John, to be honest. I think all the work and the pressure's been from Luiz. I just think, you know, every now and again, Matthew just throws out those stand-up punches like that right uppercut or the long right hand. Good jab. It's been enough just for me to favour him for the last two rounds.
Judges deciding the outcome.
You can hear Luigi's corner telling Tony to be rough.
Well, he's certainly that. But his roughness and aggression going to be enough to trump what might be superior skills?
Just landed with a good right hand there, Luiz, but a good counter punch there back from Matthews.
Nothing wrong with that.
No, good. Luiz just tries to tuck that chin behind the elbow, behind the shoulder, I should say, sorry. It doesn't quite work for him.
I've said it before, but look at the size of Matthews. When you think that he was a featherweight, goodness, he was a big fella, wasn't he?
Yeah, it's huge, yeah. Good body shot from Luiz, but then a nice little counter left out again from Matthews. That's what he needs to do, Matthews. Just respond with everything. Good right hand.
Having a lot of success with that straight right thrown over the top of the left lead of Luiz.
Well, Luiz, you know, I like Luiz. He looks quite good, but he just has no head movement. Well, not enough head movement. Throws his punches good, throws in combinations. The right sort of thing against Matthews.
And immensely fits, yes. You can tell that.
Good jab from Derry Matthews again. Luiz, good right hand.
Two or three times in that round, in this round, that right hand's come into play from Matthews.
Again, it's because of lack of head movement from Tony Luiz. Everything else about Tony Luiz's tactics are pretty good. You've got the right idea, pressurise Matthews, make him work. But don't move the head and gets caught with that right hand coming in every time. Both land them in low shots there to the body. Another low shot there from Matthews.
Foster telling Derry Matthews how it is about holding. Telling him quite emphatically. Looking like another Matthews round, though. This.
Yeah, oh, good left hand there from Luiz. Yeah, it is, John. Again, it's all the pressure from Luiz, but the quality shots, as we see there, with a lovely right hand from Matthews. Well, the quality's coming from Matthews.
Can't miss him with that right hand, can he? So, well, the way we're seeing it, we've got it there as another round for Derry Matthews, who's made a pretty good start here, the way myself and Barry Jones are seeing it. Let's now cross to Alex Steedman with a couple of other wise men.
Thanks very much. Anthony Crawley knows all about Derry Matthews. Has he made a good start?
Yeah, I do think he's made a good start, but I felt like Tony Luiz was getting a bit of a foothold in it towards the end of that last round. I've got Derry up by a point, but there's not much to split him. I think the quality's coming from Derry, the quantity's coming from Luiz, which we expected. But I think the next few rounds are going to be very interesting to see how the fight's going to pan out. Like I say, if Derry sticks to his box and he wins this, like I say, I do believe the second half will get tough for him, though.
Will do, and that's maybe where that pressure will count for Luiz. Is Derry fit enough to put up with that?
Yeah, most definitely. Look at the shape the man's in, but I mean, it's a bit different when someone's punching in the mouth, you know?
Thankfully, he's missing a few of them so far, but it's getting a bit edgy here.
I'll bear that in mind, Barry. It's a bit different when somebody's punching you in the mouth.
Can't argue with that, can you, John?
Intriguing fight, though. Still is. We've seen it in the Matthews direction, but who knows what the judges are seeing. It could be going the other way, according to their way of looking at it. The rounds have been tight.
Well, and particularly the first round, John, which could have easily gone to Luiz's. A lovely combination there from Matthews.
Good combination on the back of eating a couple of rapid left jabs, though, from Luiz. That sort of fight. I'm sure that the Louise corner will have been pretty emphatic behind the scenes about their insistence that the rules are adhered to. Gary Matthews, well, we know that it kind of is just referred to jokingly more often than not, that he does have a reputation of being a tough, hard customer, and there Louise getting away with a bit of forearm in the neck.
Yep. Good right hand again there from Matthews. A good response back from Louise, and that's what Louise needs to keep doing. Just keep throwing those punches in threes and fours. Perpetual motion coming forward, pushing Matthews back. But he's got to move that head, Louise. For me at the moment, Louise just taking too many punches before he gets there, close enough to land his own.
Well, he's walking into a lot of right hands. Still relatively fresh, still showing his fitness. It's enabling him to take them. The further the fight goes, though, you wonder. And this time it's Louise who gets the stern telling off from Howard Foster.
The left hook there from Louise.
You heard it very clearly, both fighters told there.
That's good for Matthews, 1-2, and then move out the way.
Tight guard from Luis as well.
Good response from Luis, so again, see, just keep throwing those straight punches and just don't quit.
Matthews has been warned for holding, and he was doing again there.
Good body shot there. Good body shot there coming forward from Luis, right hand to the body.
Signs that the aggression of Louise is starting to make Matthews look a little bit ragged in this round.
That's good from Matthews, oh, nice little combination. Good jab.
Tight round again.
Yeah, another very close round, wasn't it, John?
Right, you can win this if you listen to what I'm saying. Right, he's getting desperate now. The kid is coming in, he's throwing the head in. You've got to move off and left and right. Everything behind the jab, half a step back, jab, 1-2 and move. If the left hand's on, it's on. 1-2, boxing, stick to your boxing end off. When you're inside, it's just driving your throwing the head in. You're getting warm for football. Okay, so listen, 3, come on. Okay, everything behind the jab. Nice and tight when you're moving off. Jab, 1-2, double jab right hand. Up the middle every now and then and make him turn and move his feet. He's all right when he can set. He can't set if you're jabbing.
Take him back
and
we check him.
No, just do what you're doing. Don't have to take him back just yet. Yeah. Not just yet. Let's just do what you're doing. But invite him in. Use your feet, half a step back, meet him with the shot and then move.
Don't go in every time. Okay.
Don't go in every time.
We're going to come out sometimes.
Right. Harris scored that last round to Luis from Canada. 3-1 now. You've got it in Matthews' favour. Kind of bet that Tony Luis and his trainer will have watched as much of Derry Matthews as they can in the time available. I'm sure they'll have watched his most recent defeat against Stephen Ormond on that particular night. Derry, albeit that he bust a hand early in the fight, he was kind of outworked.
Yeah, he was outworked, but there was more headroom from Stephen Ormond. But these rounds are so close, aren't they, John? You know, I think Derry had a really good start to that fourth round, but then Louise coming strong at the end, so it's a...
Well, he was putting the head in there, Louise.
Good right hand there from Matthews. That's good from Derry Matthews, keep it long, but a lovely left hook from Louise. He's starting to dip low now, Louise, isn't he? Dip low and punch high. Bending his knees a little bit, throwing the left hook over the top.
Support of the crowd will be important for Matthews. Such a popular figure here on Merseyside. Assistant Louise keeps on coming. Oh, nice uppercut. Good shot from Matthews.
again, you know, Luis doing all the work, but it's scrappy, isn't it? And then the clear cut landing punches are coming from Terry Matthews.
Quantity and aggression against accuracy and quality. Now that is not allowed. He's going to get a point taken away here, I think. I think that will be the final word that he's going to get. He's talked or suggested fairly clearly in public about what he regards as dodgy refereeing, but if you put your forearm in somebody's throat, then you really do expect something to come back.
Yeah, and then after that, then Terry Matthews landed some lovely punches. With Luis trying to overcompensate for that little bit of a telling off of the referee and just charging in and abandoned having to take some nice uppercuts off Terry.
Well, he's just trying to walk through Matthews, isn't he? And I don't think at this stage that he's able to do so because there's still a lot in the tank from Matthews.
See, once Matthews feels that back leg touch that back plus the rope, he got to spin off. He can't surrender himself to the ropes or the corners. Luis would be all over him, as we're seeing. He's a good boxing on the move in this round, though, from Matthews so far.
Awful lot of holding and mauling and grabbing and pushing.
The right hand there from Luis. Again, he just doesn't quit, does he? You throw three punches, then another one, just to make sure. But Matthews wrong for me. I think he boxed well there on the move.
Scorecard now, it's four rounds to one for Derry Matthews. A few of those rounds have been close though,
so it sounds
like a commanding lead, you never know.
Well, the first round in particular, wasn't it, with Luis coming forward constantly, you know, that could have easily gone his way, and maybe the judges would probably give him that round, so you tend to think it was a lot closer on their card.
I'm sure Howard Foster will be reluctant to start taking punches away, but it might be that he has to.
The left hook there off Matthews.
Right hand from Luis, followed up by a couple of hooks.
He's strong as a bull, isn't he, this Luis? Good left hook from Matthews. And an uppercut there from Luis, and again.
Another. And this is a good attack from Luis. Corner insisting that when he gets in close, he's got to let his punches go, let his combinations fire. And he's trying his best to perform to orders. Howard Foster doing a pretty good job of allowing the action to continue, keeping a close look at things.
Well, Matthews covering up well, but you got to throw some punches back.
Well,
this is where Luis wants it.
Matthews is worried about physically getting hold of him and pushing him back. Yeah.
But this is where Luis wants it. He'd be happy where it is at the moment. Good body shot. Oh, good right hand there from Matthews.
Well, that was the best attack of the fight so far. Sustained attack from Luis. And now Matthews trying to fire back, maybe in the latter stages of this round, because it's been a Luis round so far.
Oh, yes.
Terry Matthews even has dirty Derry around the waistband of his shorts. Shorts joking reference to his reputation. But this is being a Canadian round. This is one for Tony Luiz.
Well, he's just out working, Matthews, isn't he? Again, when Matthews does let his hands go, the quality's coming from him, but Luiz just non-stop coming forward, non-stop working, and Matthews sitting on the ropes there for a good 20-odd seconds, 30 seconds.
Doesn't mind what he hits either, does he? Arms or shoulders, he just keeps coming.
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah.
And is he going to be the one to wear Matthews down? This is a good round for him.
It's a good assault there from Tony Luiz, showing great physical strength and fitness.
Oh, great left hand. Good left hand from Luiz, and Matthews felt that one.
And again, doubling up there, Luiz.
Worrying times, these, for Derry Matthews. Big body shots, and this has been a big round for Tony Luiz. Well, Matthews may have been ahead before then, but that was emphatically a round that went against him.
Some hard body shots here as well from Luiz.
Get your elbows in, he's going to come flying at you now. Yeah, how are you feeling, sir? You're all right. Give him some water on the head. All right, are you okay? You've got to box. You don't need to fight this, but I don't want to see you fight from now on. I want to see you box. You've got to keep your room behind you all the time. He's only, I told you, when he gets close, that's all he's got. Your jab, you've got to stiffen it up. You've got to keep your shape. You're bending, you meet yourself his size. That's how you make yourself big and tall, side on, and get back on that boxing again. Yeah? You're having success when you're boxing. You can do it all night.
He just kept on coming. That was a good uppercut. And another one, and another.
Yeah, and Matthews went in his shell a little bit, didn't he, for the most part of that round, where Luiz was just pure momentum going forward, just the commitment and the strength of Luiz shining through in that round.
Danny Vaughan imploring Matthews to get back to his boxing. On our card, halfway stage, 4-2 for Derry Matthews. But that was it a turning of the tide? Can Matthews regain some sort of control here? Particularly marked up as yet. The swelling maybe around the Tommy brow of Matthews, but it's nothing significant, not at this stage. He's got to find a way though to just keep Luiz off. That's better. That's the game.
Got to get that jab at the plate, Derry Matthews.
Oh, that's a good shot again from Luiz.
You can't keep Luiz off, can he, John?
No. Oh, low shots on the blind side of the referee. Howard Foster was behind. I don't think he saw it.
Nope.
And there's blood coming now from the nose of Derry Matthews. It's been a problem at times in the past. Remember when he fought Gavin Rees? Oh, now. Referee's called break. Low shot came from Matthews and then a shot after the break from Luiz.
You're better than that. Put it out, OK? No more, OK?
Crowd don't like it. The initial transgressor of the rules there was Terry Matthews with that low punch. Then Luiz taking the regulations into his own hands. And you heard clearly Howard Foster saying to Derry Matthews, don't do it, you're better than that.
We know Derry's tough, but this is turning into a Luiz sort of fight, isn't it?
Well, he's turned it into a tough man fight, hasn't he? He's turning it into a brawl, and when it's a brawl, he's the one who's winning it.
Nice from Derry there, nice little right hand, left hand.
On his last fight, Carl Dargan started as the favourite against Luiz. Highly touted, undefeated prospects, and Luiz did a number on him. And he won the fight with precisely this sort of style, just kept on coming and coming and
pressure,
coming.
Fitness and strength, isn't it? That's what's getting him through.
Better from Matthews.
Yeah, that's good. Really.
Working better behind that left-hand lead.
Oh, cracking right hand there from Matthews.
Best punch he's thrown for quite some time. Lewis takes it well, though, fair play. Again, great display of his resilience and his fitness. Lewis comes in with a hard right hand as well. And now has Matthews where he wants him, on the ropes. Matthews keeping the elbows tucked in, blocking everything though. Good round.
Hard round in every sense. The score for the two fighters and everything.
Into it a little bit, but you're having success when you're moving and you're looking apart when you're moving. Now you've got to get the elbows in and you've got to start finishing the trigger picture. Mid-range all the time. Yeah, keep your shape a little bit and get on that jab. Jab 1-2, round the sides, up the middle. Right, so you try your left hook every now and then, but when you do, you've got to make sure you dip and the chin's got the hands have got to be right back to your chin.
He's all good and you've got space between his
head. How are you feeling? Tell me, talk to me.
Don't go in everything.
Well, there's the low punch from Lewis. And then Matthews gets his own back, as you'll see in a moment. He complained to the referee. Referee didn't do anything, so he gives him that.
Oh, that left hook.
And then, after the break, comes that. A little bit of anger and a bit of feeling from both sides.
Yeah, boys will be boys, Joe, won't they? That's all that is.
You fetch that round to Tony Lewis. Could have gone the other way.
Not easily. They had so hard, didn't they? I think Lewis had a good start to the round. And Derry came back into it after that little bit of a telling off.
4-3, you've got it, to Matthews, after 7.
Good jab from Matthews, that's what he needs, more of that. We've got to stop this guy from coming forward, we've got to deter him from coming forward.
Best punch of the round, though, is that, apart from the shot to the groin, which
the
was
right hand
well
from Matthews,
was
yeah.
The right hand, yeah.
Yeah, it was. If you picked all the good shots out, all the quality shots out of the fight, they'd all come from Matthews.
Oh, he's taking a point. Point from Matthews, he's had the warning. Well, that could be a very, very important moment. Now, don't like it, needless to say.
Well, Matthews got to win this round, though. It's imperative, otherwise it's a two-point round.
Needs a big effort now, Matthews. Real roughhouse, isn't he? Taking the point from Matthews, and I think Lewis is on thin ice. Crowd wanted a point taken from him there.
And all the momentum seems to be swaying towards Tony Lewis at the moment.
Derry, the crowd chants reverberate around the Echo Arena.
Good uppercut there from Lewis.
Gary Matthews almost having to fight against an inclination to grab on and to hold on. He's already lost 1 point for that. Punches were going behind the head and he chipped a fairly solid right hand as he came in close that time. Looking to get right in the pocket every time, Lewis, and fight away and work away in close and fire in those hooks.
Good right hand there from Derry Matthews.
Matthews has done, oh, great shot from Matthews.
Cracking punch.
Lewis has got some chin. Well, I think Matthews has won this round, but he's had the point deduction.
And this is what he needed, John. He needed to win the round just to keep it level.
Could be a 9-9. Oh, now is he going to get a point deducted for use of the head? He is. Well. Well, it was a 9-9 round with the deduction. Oh, good shot.
Good right hand, definitely. And again.
What a round! How do you begin to score this?
Oof.
Well, it could have been 10-8. Matthews, for me, wins the round, yep. Which makes it 9-9. But then Luiz gets deducted a point, so 9-8.
Makes it 9-8, yeah, of course. Yeah, you score the round first, who you think's won, then you deduct the point. It's a 10-point match system, then you deduct the point. So it's 9-8 to Matthews.
We've got Matthews ahead. Let's see how the boys have got it.
We've run out of fingers. We've lost count in all the confusion. What do you make of it?
I've scored a point deduction. I've got Derry 1 up, and for me, he was having a really good round then, so the point deduction evened up. Then again, Tony Luiz come back with two good right hands at the end. I've got Derry just up, and like I thought, the second half of this fight is going to be tough. I think he needs to stick to his boxing, get behind the jab, and it'll see him all.
It's a great rally, though, from Matthews. Having lost the point, under pressure, has he got what it takes to get through these hard rounds?
Well, listen, that last round was an excellent round. I've got him one round up as well, so if he can keep doing what he's doing, he becomes champion.
Oh, it's that close. Here we go.
What a good fight. That point deduction against Tony Luiz. That could be important. We've got Derry Matthews a couple of points up. But we now move into the ninth. And it is close.
Good right hand there from Luiz to start the round. And look at this for pressure. And look, Matthews is keeping his hands up, tucked in nice, and he's trying to defend.
As I say, it's pressure, but he's struggling to find clean shots.
But Matthews got to stay off the ropes. You can't just sit there. You can't just sit on the ropes.
And then going in again.
As soon as his leg touches that back rope, you got to spin, you got to pivot off the front foot, Derry Matthews. Got to get the big part of the ring to his back.
So much experience, Derry Matthews, and he's come from behind in periods of adversity before, right the way through his career, and this is where he doesn't want to be.
It's a great effort, though, isn't it, from Tony Luiz.
Is terrifically fit.
Well, the first half of the round's been all Luiz now, so Matthews needs to respond with something.
Keeps coming forward. Every time he comes forward, the head is coming close, and it was the word again from the referee.
And also the fact that he's constantly coming forward will that have an effect in his close rounds, or the judges see it.
Well, this has been a Luiz round,
yeah,
so
big,
far quite
big
emphatically
round. Good right hand there from Matthews, and the movement's good from Matthews here, right hand and moving.
So much at stake for Derry Matthews.
Nice little 1-2 there from Matthews. Again, Luiz just coming in forward in straight lines. No head movement.
No real signs as yet that Luiz is starting to flag. Still, he maintains this buzzsaw sort of approach.
He looks fresher than Daisy, doesn't he, Luiz? It's unbelievable. So fit.
Could all come down to the three rounds from here on in. But I would suspect that it almost certainly does do. It's been a Tony Luiz round, though, for me.
Yeah, me as well.
And big. At work, Matthews, who hasn't found the strength to fight him off.
Oh, good right hand, left hook for Matthews. Yeah, but not enough. Good Luiz round.
Good round from Luiz.
Stick to what you do. John, you're looking stronger here now. You're looking the one who's looking, he's feeling it. You're looking for him.
You get hit with jabs and crosses when you're standing in front of him and don't do anything. Okay. What are you going to do? Your son is at home watching. What are you going to tell him? You forgot what we did? We forgot what we're supposed to do. You, okay? You got three rounds.
Great bit, suck that in.
You got three rounds. I want to see both hands being used. Okay? Combinations.
Big breath, kid.
Okay? You got to throw in combinations.
Match up jabs. Don't just let him jab.
Don't just let him jab and stand there and wait for him. You can't wait for this guy. Either move, get completely out of range when you pull the gap.
stirring stuff in the Tony Luiz corner. Shades of Teddy Atlas when he spoke to Michael Moore, that famous speech against Evander Holyfield. What are you going to tell your son? He's back home watching.
Sound the voice about punching in combinations, and that's true, that's what he needs to do.
Look at this. They're fighting like a man possessed.
Just swarming all over Matthews, not giving him a chance to work.
Oh, is he going to take another point? No, no. He thought about it. So the good start then, first 30 seconds from Tony Luiz. How's Matthews going to respond?
Starting to look a bit tired for me, Derry Matthews. Good jab from him, though, but Luiz is the one with all the energy at the moment. Really needs that second win right now, Derry Matthews.
Right hand from Matthews, quality shot.
Good timing there.
Buzz of applause from his corner. Catching Luiz as he came in. And again. Luiz put an awful lot into that first 30 seconds. And he's just looked a little bit more laboured thereafter.
Good jab as well from Matthews. Left hook back up on Luiz. He won't be denied, this Canadian.
Matthews needs to get back to his boxing and needs to find something somehow to try and halt the relentless forward march of Tony Luiz. Good again from Matthews, who's perhaps had the better of things after that early onslaught.
Yeah, but here's Luiz, comes Luiz again.
Not anything clean, though, Barry.
No. He had a good start in the first half of the fight of the round, though, Luiz. And Matthew, you're right, Matthew's come back into it in the second half.
First 30 seconds, really, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Stirring words from the corner, certainly inspired him for the initial onslaught. Going to lose another point the way it's going. Warned about use of the head again. Matthews able to keep him off and land a few decent shots from range. Oh, what a good round. Again.
It's been a cracking fight so far, hasn't it? It really has.
He pays your money and takes your choice again,
it's,
don't
it's
you?
It's like one of those.
Initial onslaught, 30 seconds.
Yeah,
barrage from Luiz, and then thereafter, Matthews is getting the better.
He's going to throw everything at you. Now you've got to stay switched on, and all your experience has got to come into it. Jab and one, two and move.
Two rounds of boxing,
pure boxing. Every time he comes, let's just box and move. Jab and move. Chin down, hands up. He's going to get desperate. He's going to throw everything at you, yeah? But look, come on, it's only what we've been talking about. Is here now, we can see everything you can. Okay, now breathe. Come on, breathe. You look really, really strong. It looks like you've got another gear to go in here. But you don't have to. I want you to just stick with what you're doing, OK? And I left you heavy now and then, and look up the middle.
Come on,
so it's jab one, two, and look for that.
You've just got to tear the second round.
That's all. It comes late on. That's all.
You will have your own ideas of the scores back home. On our cards, or on Barry's card, to be precise, it is absolutely dead level, and it's down to the final two rounds. Into round 11. And that early onslaught from Tony Luiz on Barry's card was enough to edge him that last round.
It's so hard, isn't it, John? Because all the pressure's coming from Luiz, all the forward motion, but then the cleaner shots tend to be mainly from Derry Matthews.
Nice body shot from Luiz. You heard it thud home, left hook.
Good right hand there off the rope from Matthews. You got to dig deep now, Matthews, and try and get that quality of boxing.
These are the last two rounds.
But he needs to do that quality of boxing for the full 3 minutes now, not just the last half of the rounds.
It's been an engrossing fight right the way through. as we thought it would be.
Good left hook there from Matthews and a right hand.
Managing to make Luis miss with the attempted punches coming back. Again, now Luis does get in with a right uppercut.
Good left hook from Luis.
Heads coming in close.
Both landing with left hooks there.
Shake your head at this one, and how are they going to be scoring it? Could we be in for a really tight decision? Could we be in for a split decision? Maybe even a draw, you never know. Matthews has landed more clean shots in this round so far.
Yeah, he's boxed a little bit better on the move, hasn't he, in this round so far, Matthews. So far, John, that is. But this Tony Luis hasn't stopped coming forward. He's just been tremendous, hasn't he?
I thought he threw so much into the early stages of that last round. There's almost a sense that thereafter, as he just punched himself out a little, he's throwing single shots now, yep, rather than the punches in bunches prior to that.
He just landed with a good right hand over the top there, though, Luis.
Tony Luis for me just starting to look more tired, maybe for the first time. Yeah. His work rate has noticeably dropped.
It is for the first time in the fight. That's what Matthew needs to keep him on, right on, at the end of the punches, right long range.
Forearm into the throat, and he's on dangerous ground again. And you see again, he's lunging in behind, yep, the single shot, Tony Luis.
Matthew's got to keep it at distance, can't even get close for a second. Good right hand.
Right, so how did you have that round? I thought that was a Matthews round.
Yeah, I got that for Matthews.
So a Matthews round, we've got it by one to Derry Matthews. Yeah. Alec, how have Anthony and Peter got it?
It's hard to keep up, but without sitting on the fence, I think everything's sitting on this last round. Everything's sitting, you know, on this last round. Running this last round wins the fight for me.
The cleaner work has come from Derry, but there's the momentum and pressure that's been coming from Elise. It's a classic sort of pick and fight, Peter.
Yeah, I mean, he's got a bigger work rate, but they're not landing a lot of shots. And like you say, Derry's shots are landing, so, you know, it is on this last round, definitely.
It's up for grabs, John. And the amazing thing is, Luis has never been 12 rounds before. You wouldn't know it.
No, he certainly wouldn't. Although he did look tired in that last round. He was no longer throwing the volume of punches that he had done prior to that. Let's hear, if we can, last instructions from Howard Foster. He'll give them a real strong word. Let's keep it clean, no holding. Steve Lillis reckons that a whole stack of the rounds very, very close. Reckons it could be all on the last round. Jim Rosenthal, he has Derry Matthews just ahead. What a great fight.
Well, it's been absolutely tremendous, hasn't it? And you've got to give Luis the credit, because he hasn't stopped coming forward all night. Crude at times, sometimes clever with the using the forearms and getting the head inside, you know. Good gamesmanship.
Matthews trying to keep a range, trying to keep boxing through this last round. Huge effort again from Luis. He's really digging deep.
You got to throw straight punches, Matthews. Straight shots, long shots. Fast, they got to come back fast as well.
Minute then maybe has gone to Luis of this last round.
As per usual.
And Matthews now has to dig in, has to find pride, accuracy and a little bit of boxing ability.
You got to use every inch of those long levers. It's Derry Matthews. Don't let Luis shorten the gap. Don't throw hooks, just throw straight punches. Straight punches, twos and threes, and keep moving. But at the moment, in this round, John Luis just hustling him out of it again.
Single uppercut off the ropes from Matthews. complaining to the referee. Not a time for complaining. You kind of got to be taking the law into your own hands here.
Yeah, no, he has. Good right hand from Luis. Good right hand there, though, from Matthews. Tremendous finish to a really good fight.
We're inside the last minute. Luis, for me, is winning this last round. How decisive is that going to be?
Good uppercut there from Matthews, but then Luis just walks through it and lands a left hook.
Immensely committed performance from the Canadian. He knew that he had to, in all probability, win big on home turf if he was going to take it. Has he done enough?
Good from Matthews here, lovely fast hands.
Matthews trying to repel an opponent who's just charging in and comes right in with a head again.
And a lovely left hook as well from Luis.
Well, that's a Luis round. And on your card, Barry, I'm just totting up. Yep. That makes it dead level if that's a Tony Luis round.
Yes, it does, John, really does.
You got it as a draw. Matthews waves to the crowd and takes some support. Has he done enough, though? What a fight.
It was a tremendous fight, a battle. Every round was a proper battle. But it was so many close rounds, weren't there, where, you know, you could have picked really either one for whatever you prefer, whatever you fancied. But for me, I think Derry just needed to stay on the back foot, keep it at long range in that last round, and he couldn't stop Luis from coming forward yet again. And I think Luis took the last round to get the draw.
Matthews thanking his supporters, asking his people at ringside how they've got it, and asking us how we've got it. Well, we've got it very, very close indeed. He thinks he's won it. I'm not so sure. Art Foster, I think he's just saying it's a great fight and not really passing too much of an opinion in there, I don't think. We have got it dead level, but a lot of the rounds were very close, and that very fact could lead to some widely divergent scores. Yeah, wouldn't be a surprise.
No, you wouldn't be surprised, you. Because, again, it's what you prefer sometimes in a fight, but in some very, very close rounds. And it was very much someone starting fast, someone finishing fast.
Well, do they think that they've won it? Certainly couldn't be accused of leaving anything in the gym, could he? He's come over here and given it absolutely everything. May have been technically the inferior fighter. Goodness me, he absolutely gave his all. Derry thinks he's got it. Derry thinks he's got it. He's been looking, I think, taking a peep at the cards, and he thinks he's done it. Not going to go down very well with the Canadian corner, I don't think. We might hear a few words of protestation from them. But Derry Matthews reckons he's got it, and maybe he has been tipped the wink. WBA man is there at ringside. The tallies have been made. It's been handed to Mark Burdis. And you can see there that I think that a little bit of information might have leaked out. And I think that Derry has probably got this. That we can now hear, we can go into the ring. Moments of anxiousness for both fighters. But it looks as though Matthews might have got it. Here's Mark Burdis.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of boxing, we go to the scorecard. We have a unanimous decision. Judge Carroza, 114-112. Judge Legnow, 114-112. Dave Paris, 115-112. The winner and the new WBA interim lightweight champion of the world. In the blue corner from Liverpool, Derry Matthews.
The celebrations are for the pride of Liverpool, Derry Matthews.
Ladies and gentlemen,
what a tough fight that was. And if ever a round of applause was deserved, it's the round of applause for Tony Luis, who just shrugged his shoulders with a look of resignation. He thinks that he's been a little shortchanged here. He thinks that he won it. but Derry Matthews has the belt around his shoulders and coming across now to give a moment of congratulation to Tony Lewis and going around the ring together now. And I think rightly, the two of them taking a terrific round of applause from the crowd after what was a very, very good fight indeed.
Thank you, John. Thanks to Barry as well. One more fight still to come from us here at the Echo. Do not go away. Scottish flyweight Ian Butcher still to come. We'll be talking to both those guys. A grueling, tough, punishing fight for Derry Matthews, who stays on course for that world title dream. 114, 112, a couple of the judges, 115, 112. I have to say, Steve, without wishing to pat myself on the back, I had it 114, 112 as well, but a desperately, desperately close, tough affair.
I'll be honest, I had Lewis by one round, but absolutely no argument. Four of those rounds, when I marked my scorecard, I got crosses by, I couldn't split them, and I had to go one way or the other. Only one I did score level. Such a close, close fight. I can see why they were grieved, and I can see why Derry's won it, but what a fantastic story in his 49th fight. I remember seeing him as a featherweight lose on one of my Amir Khan's earlier shows to Choi, the Mongolian guy, and I thought it was over for him when he got stopped in about five rounds. What a fantastic story, and it couldn't happen to a nicer fella.
There's one thing, Anthony, about this game, and Derry said it before the fight, he's in the best shape of his life. If he hadn't been, he'd have lost it.
That's what got him home tonight. Like I say, it was so close, really could have gone either way, but if Derry wouldn't have been in the best shape of his life, he would have got watered down and stopped late on. But what a fantastic fight for me. It was a great fight to be here, to be sat close ringside and watch.
It's easy for us, isn't it, to say, don't let him get you on the ropes, use the jab, get him away, but Lewis just didn't have any reverse gears.
Lewis was relentless. We kept him on the corner, work, and he was thinking at times, you think, give him something else, but no, Derry weathered the storm. Like I say, it really was so close, like Steve just said then. You could see how it went for Lewis, you could see how it went for Derry. I thought it was either quantity or quality, depending on what you liked, is who you had the winner.
Everything came his way. He knew what was coming. A bit of a head came, a bit of an elbow came. But those were really worrying moments for Derry when Lewis might have felt that the fight was going his way.
Incredible. There was times, you know, we were sort of seeing Derry take on. We were thinking, was he having a breather? Was he hurt? You know, there was one end of one of the late rounds he was hurt by a left hook. Like, you know, what the job Danny Vaughan, a guy at the conditioner, Jason Lowndes, called the Taffinator, have done with him, Marbella, is second to none. All credit to Danny Vaughan, because he's had a rough time lately with results and one thing and another. And the job they've done with him and keeping his motivation when the first fight fell through against April was fantastic. Yeah. So pleased for them all.
And this game isn't about dreams, it's about reality. But the dream of fight number 50 and the world title lives on.
Yeah, of course it does. He's interim champion now. So he's thereabouts. I'm not sure what the situation is just yet. But he's right in the pitch for a world title shot. A fight like that, you deserve one.
You've had a couple of tilts together. You never know down the line, you might make it
a
hat-trick.
Never rule a first fight out with me and Derry. I think like a lot of British boxing fans, what I see it, I know we'd both have it. Hopefully one day that first fight will happen.
And the Canadian, first time over 12 rounds, he looked in shape to go more, though he'd given his absolute everything.
In fairness, he did have a fight last night, so he'd been in a training camp, but, you know, he only flew her on Tuesday. But on the flip side, it was hard for Derry with a constant change of opponents. He hadn't prepared for that.
They both
leave that ring with immense credit tonight.
Absolutely. Well, let's have a word with them both. I'm delighted to say they both sat down to have a chat with Alex.
And we'll start with the champion with a belt around his waist, Derry Matthews, after all the hard work in your 49th fight, after the ups and downs. How does that feel?
The roller coaster's over. Listen, it was a hell of a fight. It was tough. I hit me both hands going in about round five or six. And I tell you what, he's a warrior. He's a tough, tough man. He's got some chin on him. And listen, I'm champion of the world. I'm interim champion of the world only because the world champion wouldn't fight me. You know, it's been a roller coaster the last few days, and thanks to my management team and my promoter, Frank Warren, and, you know, everyone at MGM, they've stuck by me and they believed in me, and tonight it's paid off.
It was a very, very close fight, Tony. I've got to bring you in. 2 points on two cards. Some of our commentators thought it was very, very tight. Did you think you'd done enough?
Under the circumstances, I think I could have done more. To be honest, first, Derry boxed a good fight. He did what he had to do. And used his jab well and tried to establish range, tied me up inside to not let me get off. I think the ref could have let us punch our way out a little bit more and let me fight my fight inside. I thought he was breaking us very quick. And sometimes, you know, there is an experienced veteran. He knows when he would dip his head low inside on the outside of my shoulder and then come up, I would put my forearm just to keep from getting headbutted. Not an elbow, just a forearm here. Floyd Mayweather has made a career out of it. And the referee's calling me for that. That's a defensive maneuver. I mean, stuff like that to keep me from not fighting my fight. Very quick breaks. So that's, you know, but so under the circumstances, probably didn't do enough to win, but tonight's his moment, and he boxed a good fight.
I thought, Danny, that the cleaner work came from Derry. There was a lot of pressure from Tony, a lot of pressure, but I thought the cleaner work came from Derry.
The good shots were coming, the cleaner shots, you know, the quality shots were coming from Derry. He looked good behind the jab. We knew Tony would come all day, and we knew once he got close he was going to work and score points, but the cleaner work every round was coming from Derry.
How much did the work of the Taffinator help you out tonight?
Oh, just work tremendous. You only have to look at the shape. I mean, not just that, the work Danny's put in with me as well, you know. We're both away from our families for 12 weeks. It's been a hard camp. It's been, you know, it's been a bit of a roller coaster. And you know, 1 minute I'm fighting Abel, 1 minute I'm fighting a southpaw with a big punch. Next minute I'm fighting a conformable fighter who's game as anything, who's tough as they come. You know, so the last couple of days been a roller coaster. But the professional I am, the people I've got around me, you know, the fight happened and I'm champion.
You said one thing wrong. It's not the end of the journey.
No.
Just yet. Not just yet. How does the story evolve over the next sort of 3 months, shall we say?
Well, you know, he won that full title, I think. You know, and now that it's in control of another guy, it's not Abril anymore. Perez is a good fight. It's a tough fight for Derry. But, you know, he's shown tonight that he thrives in a tough fight. You know, Tony came in, he absolutely gave everything. I thought he'd slow down at some point, but he seemed to pick up more and more momentum as the fight went on. But, you know, I couldn't be prouder of Derry, and I'm, you know, just absolutely over the moon for him. There are four or five different fights that I think we can line up for Derry. But I think tonight's about enjoying tonight, and, you know, I don't think Rollercoaster's nowhere near finished, because this guy's got plenty of fight left in him.
There's got to be a book and a film there somewhere.
I can see Andy Collin, the commentator box. Listen, I said from day one that I win a world title, I'll give Andy the fair shot. I mean, he's a great fighter who I respect a lot. I know Liverpool and Manchester love that fight. So, you know, if I do get awarded the world title, you know, me and Andy can happen. It's about the promoter sitting down and you know, making it happen for me and Andy. It's about, you know, putting bums on seats. And I think me and Andy tell any arena out. He's a great fighter who we have a lot of respect for. And, you know, it's about me now fighting who I want to fight. And I think that'll be a great fight.
We enjoyed that. It was a hell of a fight. Well done to you. Well done.
Cheers. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. All right, Derek.